Welcome to Ekandan Development Center, Majlis Arts and Science College, Paramanur. I'm Habiba from Department of English. Reading is to the mind what exercise is to the body. Once again, welcome to the session. I hope that now you must have guessed what's the topic of today. Let's see through a reading text. Now read the words displayed on the screen. Now read the statement. Now be a little quick in this time. How fast could you read it? Students are so passionate to read. So in this session, let's see reading skill. After watching this lesson, students will learn to use different strategies for reading extended text and message. Then students will be able to recognize different vocabulary and also learn to reference in textual message. And students also make a comparison between denotative and connotative meaning of the text. Language plays a vital role in our daily life. Without language, we cannot communicate or we cannot make any sense. English language learning involves proper integration of four skills, that is LSRW, listening, speaking, reading and writing. For effective learning, reading comprehension techniques plays a vital learning for linguistic proficiency. So among the four macro skills of learning, reading plays a vital role. Reading assumes a greater significance as it is the foundation of learning a second language or a foreign language. Reading means decoding the printed or written material, or in other words, reading is a process of looking into a written material or a printed text and converting into an audible sound. Reading is a receptive skill in a written mode. In a reading process, the reader is engaged in an active process and the reader usually reacts mentally, physically and emotionally. Now, what are the characteristics of reading? First, reading is an intricate process. Then, reading is a visual process so that a good eyesight is required for the process of reading. Then, reading is an active process, so while engaging in a reading, the learner has to pay meticulous attention for reading. Now, what are the purpose of reading? Every reader has a set of aim or intention behind his reading. So, the purpose of reading may be for pleasure and enjoyment, and sometimes to get an overview of the passage. Sometimes the reader is asked to pay a critical or analysis of the study. It is very essential to have a glance on the sub-skills of reading. What are the sub-skills of reading? First, recognize the script. Then, recognize the vocabulary and recognize the basic syntactic patterns. Then, elicit the main points. Then, distinguish the main ideas from the supporting points. And also, very important to identify the mood of the writer or the attitude of the writer. While reading, a person's eyes move a series of gems separated by short stops. This stop is called fixation. And reading takes place during this fixation. The number of words reads in one complete movement of the eye is called eye span. In another words, the length between the eye span is the fixation. The longer the eye span, the more fluent is the reader. Stages in the process of reading. There are mainly three stages in the process of reading. Now let's see the stages one by one. First, recognition stage. Here the learner simply recognizes the spoken word in its written or printed form. Then structuring stage. Here the learner identifies the syntactic relationship of the items. Then interpretation stage. Here the learner comprehends what exactly the meaning. Types of reading. In a broad sense, reading is four types. First, intensive reading, then extensive reading, loud reading and silent reading. Let's see one by one. First, intensive reading. Intensive reading means a detailed study of the passage and minute attention is given to each aspect of the passage and it concentrates on the language and it gives attention to thematic, linguistic and technical aspect of the language. Extensive reading means a non-detailed study of the passage and it's for getting an overall idea of the passage and always its aim is non-linguistic. An extensive reading cultivates a learning habit or a learning interest towards people and it also cultivates a taste for reading. And sometimes extensive reading for pleasure and enjoyment and the examples for extensive material are novels, comic books, etc. Then loud reading. Loud reading means reading aloud, and readers have to pay meticulous attention while using stress, rhythm and intonation. Then silent reading. Silent reading means reading silently without producing sound audible to others. The other types of reading such as scanning, skimming and skipping. Let's see one by one. First, scanning. It's a way of reading in which the learner reads quickly throughout the text to get a specific information, and here the learner ignores anything he is not looking for. For example, scanning a telephone book. And in scanning, you may not be read from the beginning to the end. You can leave all those things. For example, if you want to find out the meaning of the word witches from a dictionary, you will start from the V, then I, then R. Then probably you might have found the word and its meaning. Next, skimming is a way of reading in which the learner reads the whole passage rapidly to get the gist of the passage. And this reading may be for to get a rough idea or to see what the book is all about. And here the learner is very conscious of what he is reading. For example, newspaper reading, reading quickly the whole paper to get the general idea of the news. The next type is skipping. It's a way of reading in which the reader reads the whole passage, leaving out the unimportant, and this type of reading need not be fast. Now let's see some reasons for poor reading, or what are the causes of poor reading. First, ignorance of the importance of reading, then lack of motivation and lack of libraries in the school and faulty examination system. Now, how to overcome it? How can we improve the speed of reading? First of all, make a firm decision to improve the speed. Then regular practice, read interesting books, read speedily, then make a self-assessment of reading speed, enjoy reading and develop a good eye span. So, practicing all these things, any reader can improve the speed of reading. Now, before concluding this section, let's see some of the qualities of a good reader. What are the qualities of a good reader? First, audibility, reasonable speed, good flow, correct pronunciation, proper use of intonation and stress, and fluency. That's all for today. Now, start reading today itself. I hope the session was useful and you all implement all these strategies to improve your reading. Thank you for watching.